Hey guys, what's up? So in this video, I will talk about the Cucumber plugin which we need to add in the Eclipse, as well as I will talk about how to design the feature file and what are the dependency we need to add in the project to work with Cucumber scripting, right? So what I did here is I just created one Maven project. It's a plain Maven project. So when you create a Maven project, and I'm using JDK 1.8 in my project library, so we can see that src main java and src test java will get created by default, and there'll be something called pom.xml. so Maven will create one pom.xml. here we can give the dependencies which we want to download as a part of this project. So I've added one Cucumber Java dependency, which you will get it from Google, one TestNG dependency, Cucumber TestNG dependency, log4j dependency, Selenium dependency, and TestNG dependency. So these five dependencies which I have added here, this we can get it from the Google itself, right? Or I will share this project. So what you guys can do is you guys can add these dependencies in your project and it will work, right? Apart from these dependencies, we need to add one plugin to the Eclipse so that we will get proper syntax when we write a feature file. So we can go to the help menu of the Eclipse. In the help menu of the Eclipse, we have something called install. We'll go to the Eclipse marketplace. We'll go here, and here in the find options, it will take some time. It will fetch all the available software which Eclipse has, and then in the find we can write a Cucumber. Okay, so wait for some time. Yeah, here we can write Cucumber and click on go. So when we write Cucumber and click on go, what happens is you can see that the first one, Cucumber Eclipse plugin, installed. So this is already installed in my system. If in your case you will get an option called install, so click on install, do next, and this Cucumber plugin will get installed in your system, right? If let's say if it is not available to the Eclipse marketplace, what you guys can do is go to the help, go to the install new software, right? And here you can write Cucumber, right? So this plugin is added in my Eclipse. What you guys can do is you guys can copy this plugin from the Google itself, click on add, and just here write Cucumber features, or just any name has no meaning at all, and this URL is very important. So this URL basically will have the Cucumber update sites. I mean, this will have the Cucumber plugin, like http cucumbergithub.com cucumber-eclipse/update-site. So this has a Cucumber plugin. Once you will do that, you can see that the plugin will come here and do next, finish, right? This will get installed. So if you are not able to do from Eclipse marketplace, then only do it from here, right? Now once this is done, right click pom.xml, do go run as Maven install. To do that, it will download all the required library which you need to have for your project, and then go and click on update Maven project. To click on update project and update the project. Once this is done, if you look at the src main java and src test java, two folder which got generated, and here inside that I have created some dummy package, cucumber tutorial.pageobjects. There I'll be writing all the page objects. This is step definition. Cucumber.step definition is very important folder where we'll be writing the definitions of the feature file. Dot demo I have given. I'll show one demo and then we'll start with actual coding. And then we have another package called step definitions.facebook registration. So I'll show with the Facebook registrations how we can do Facebook registration through the Cucumber. Right, now we need to write the feature file, which is very, very important. So for that, we'll create one src main resource. In the resources folder, we will keep all the features file. So I'll go to the project here, properties. I'll go to the Java build path, sources, I'll go click on add folder, go to the SRC main, click on create new folder and create the sources and click on finish. Click on OK, click on apply and OK. So you can see it here, SRC main resources has been created. Now inside the resources, we'll create one folder called features file. Right, inside the feature files, I'll create a file, okay, and let's say I will write demo dot. This extension is very important. For any feature file, you have to write demo dot feature. Okay, click on finish. So when you click on finish, you can see that one feature file got created, demo dot feature, and automatically whatever keyword we have to use, right, whatever Gherkin keywords we have to use, it will get generated automatically. For author, we have to use author keyword. For feature, we have to use feature. For scenario, we have to use scenario. For given, like some preconditions, when, some key actions which you want to perform, then like when you perform some key actions, now you want to do the validations of the outcome. And but this is just a step, so you want to add additional step, you can add by using and but. Scenario outline, which is nothing but data driven kind of things where you want to run the script for the multiple times. Examples, background, when you want to write a data table, you can use a pipe. And for placeholder, you can use angle bracket. For comments, double comments. So basically these are the tags, I will say these are the tags, Gherkin tags, which we are going to use when we'll write a feature file. And this is the template of the feature file which got generated by default. You can see that this is the reference we can use when we are writing our own feature file. So it's like if you look at @tag, @tag1, @tag2, so this is nothing but the list of scenario which we can write with the tag, right? Tag1, tag2. Inside the tag we have a feature, like what feature, let's say Facebook registration is one feature, right? And inside that we can define the scenario, like register with valid user, register with invalid email address. So we can define the multiple scenario, and we can write given and when and then, right? Given, like you have some preconditions which will come as a part of given. And when means you are going to perform some actions, and like when you are performing some actions, it need to have some more actions, so you can use with and when your actions has been performed, then you want to validate something, then use then, right? Similarly here, for the data driven kind of things, let's say we want to run this scenario multiple times. So when we write this table with the same name here, value and status, all three columns should match here. Your test will run two times because this has two records, name one, name two, 5, 7, success and fail. So this scenario will get executed two times. So this is nothing but a feature file, right, which has a list of steps to be executed, right? Now how to run this feature file? Pretty simple. Right click, run as Cucumber feature. So when we do run as Cucumber feature, okay, so it is not getting executed. What we will do is whatever dummy code was generated here, okay, let me remove that. Yeah, now let me run that. Yeah, so we can see that by default your feature file got executed. This is the beginning what we had. Here you are getting one message saying that you can implement missing steps with the snippets below. Like this is the method which will get generated automatically, which we need to implement. So what we will do, we'll copy all the method which get generated by this feature file, and we'll go to SRC main Java. We'll go to the step definitions. A step definition is very important, guys, where we are going to write the definitions of the feature file steps. Here I will just write one class. Let's say I'll write demo. So I'm just writing a demo because this is just a demo purpose. Then we'll write actual coding going forward. Demo step definition. right? Demo step definitions. Now click on finish. So one class will get generated. Inside that we can paste entire things. So when we paste, now we need to import. So we will import all the required library given, and this is the pending exceptions because the code is not ready, so it will throw pending exceptions. Once the code is ready, we will remove this pending exceptions. Now we'll import the when and anything else. Yeah, we'll import the then. Yeah, so now this is the dummy step definitions, right? So this is your feature file. Now if you look at the difference, you will make out now when we run first time what happens. This dummy step definitions got generated, right? Now we have this step definitions. Now we have the step definition. Inside that, what we can do now is we can write the Selenium code, right? Usually what we do inside that, we write a Selenium code. So this is just a demo purpose. I'm not going to write any Selenium code. Now let me do one thing. Let me run one more time. Does it get executed or not? Not sure. So we'll run one more time. I'll go here, right click, run as Cucumber feature. Yeah, so you can see that one thing here is you are getting now pending exception, right? You are getting now pending exceptions. Why you are getting pending exceptions now? Because now you have already method copied here. Your step definitions has been copied here, but it is pending state. Selenium code has not been written, so we are getting that pending status. Now we are not getting that right. I mean, we are not getting that the method name generated what we had earlier. Why? Because we are already added the step definitions. Now what I'll do? I'll remove all the pending exceptions, which means this feature while when we'll run the feature file, it will understand that code has been written. Though we are not writing it, I am just removing that pending exception. Let me remove all pending exceptions and then I will run one more time. Yeah, I removed all the pending exceptions now. And now I will go and I will run the demo feature file one more time. Run. Now we can see that it is saying that three scenario which has been passed and total 13 steps got executed. Okay, now we are getting it, right? Now we are not getting that the method to write the code, and we are not getting exceptions also. Why? Because this is already a step definition is already added. Now let me refresh the project, right? I refresh the project, and if you look at now, go to the target folder. Here you, as of now, what you have? Maven-archiver. You don't have any report as of now. For report, we will see that how we can generate the report. So that's how from the feature file we can convert to the step definitions. And the step definitions, what we need to do is inside the step definitions, we need to write the Selenium code. When we write the Selenium code, it will get executed automatically. And when you will run the feature file, this feature file will look for the step definitions, corresponding step definitions, and it will get executed automatically. Right? Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this. That's how we can set up the project, and that's how we can add the plugin, and that's how we will write a feature file, and this feature file will convert to the step definition. And the step definitions, when we run the feature file, automatically your step definitions will get called. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video, and all codes will be uploaded to my YouTube channel.